Before I begin, if you are experienced with loading maps and mods in Quake, including the re-release, this video is not really for you, so go ahead and click on the link above to find something more appealing. However, if you use the Steam or Epic Games version of Quake using the new KEX-based engine and you want more content, or maybe you have friends that are new to Quake and you want to turn them on to some classic or new community content, then this video is for you. This project is headed up by Amorpher, and the web hosting is provided by Joel B. The foundation for all of this was started by Jay Piola, who figured out how all this worked when the remastered version of Quake was released. These are people who have done a lot for the Quake community, so please thank them if you get a chance. You are probably familiar with the add-on menu in the re-release. These are curated mods and maps that id Software and Bethesda have cleared with the creators to include in the official release, both on consoles and PC. All this content is really amazing, but there's not a whole lot to choose from compared to what's out there. So these community members have decided to go ahead and make a curated list of their own, and it's extremely easy to get up and running and download a bunch of new and older content. It's literally a matter of copy and pasting a web address. There's a simple website that will guide you through it. I'm going to show you how to do it here, but I encourage you to please go to the website and read through the instructions. It will only take you a few minutes, and you'll be an expert at this in no time. Additionally, if you're interested in testing, there are even more releases from the community to check out. You can also find information and details on how to get your own projects on the mod server, so please go check this website out. The standard add-on menu points to a web server, and there's a simple configuration file that points the game to download the official content. With this new mod server, it's basically the same idea, but it's community content you'll download from a private server. You aren't going to break anything doing this, and it's very easy to undo if you want to go back to the default settings. There's a small batch file you can download that will put everything back where it was if anything seems messed up. All you have to do to get this up and running is to add an argument to the command line when you launch Quake through Steam or the Epic Game Store. Now, I'm only going to cover the Steam version because I don't have the Epic Game Store installed to show you how that works, but the website, as I mentioned, has all the information you need, and this is very simple to do on either platform. So once you're on the Quake page on Steam, on the right-hand side, there's a clickable gear icon. Select Properties, and that will bring you to Launch Options. As you can see here, I've added dash skip movies, which will get rid of the Bethesda intro and other movies, so you'll go right into the game menu. Now, as you can see here, I'm not automatically connecting to Bethesda.net, and I have to escape out and go back. It's just a quirk. I don't know if this happens for everybody, but it's happening to me as I record this video. Anyway, to connect to the community server, all you have to do is copy and paste a specific string into this box, and you can find that text in the comments below and on the website that I'll link below as well. So now, you close this window and launch the game as usual, go to the add-ons menu, and you'll see a selection of curated community content that is not part of the official release. All of these have been tested, and the descriptions will note whether co-op is tested or not. There will be some screenshots in most cases, and information about what you're about to play. You can click on download, and it loads just like the curated content does. You activate the content, and then you're playing that mod or map pack. Very simple. It's worth noting that multiplayer will work for the most part, although it can be buggy depending on the mod or map you're attempting. So be aware there are some minor issues here and there. Also, instructions for how to make multiplayer work are included on each entry on the list. Just make sure your friends have the same content as you do, using the same method. That's it! The list of content is growing every day, and there's a Discord server I will link to below to find out more, or to get involved with testing, or just to ask questions. Now, there's one more thing to note. When this command line is added to Launch Options, you can play any of the official add-ons you have already downloaded. But if you want to download others, remove the text from the Launch Options, and you'll be able to download official content from the BethesdaNet servers as usual. Please review the website and check out the Discord for more detailed info I haven't covered here. Have fun, and thanks for hanging in there. We'll see you in the next video.